Ladies and gentlemen, dear fans of IFA, welcome. Hopefully you had a good couple of days. And this morning, obviously, you have had you've already heard plenty of numbers and statistics to give you pause for thought. Our friends at GFU provided an excellent overview on the big trends driving our industry. This gives you a head start when you come to Berlin in September and join us at IFA 2019. And just now, as I said, you heard from Margot Edelman with her deep insights on trust and how difficult it is for the new technologies to gain the trust of the public. Trust is at the heart of every relationship, whether that's the relationship between consumers and companies or between business partners. Trust is built through what you say and, even more crucially, what you do. Trust happens when people see and experience what you do actually matches your promises. And that brings me to my topic today, the role of IFA in our industry. If you have been in the past to one of our IFA Global Press conferences, then you will probably expect me to talk you and to take you through IFA's success in numbers and in loving detail. But don't you worry, I won't. Yes, IFA continues to grow, and yes, we have had another record year. And if you want numbers, here are the numbers. Instead, today I want to talk to you about the changing role of IFA in our industry. It's the year 2019. Why do we still need real-world events? Why do you even come here to our global press conference? I know it's Andalusia in April, who could say no, but the answer is different. Haven't we all gone digital and live much of our professional lives in a virtual world? After all, the first journalists from Generation Z are set to join our ranks and are here in this room. They will be the first generation of truly digital natives, people who have been born into an always-on, always-connected and highly mobile digital world. But here's my prediction. Regardless of when you were born, whether you are a baby boomer or a member of Generation Y, a millennial or from Generation Z, you know that attending IFA Berlin is an invaluable experience. It's not just a matter of be there or be square, no, it's a question of be there or miss out on the future. And it's a matter of trust. And that's where I continue on Margot's presentation. You want to know that innovation is real, not vaporware, powered by nothing but promises. We all know that innovation does not happen in a straight line or at an even pace. Yes, there have been years when innovation seemed to be rather slow. In other years, the speed is absolutely breathtaking. But sometimes it's difficult to tell. And I believe that's because we are all a bit too close to the action. Maybe we are jaded. To appreciate innovation, we need to take a step back and look how much our world has actually changed. For our industry, IFA plays a much more fundamental role. You have probably heard me speak about co-innovation before, at last year's GPC and at the opening of 2018. If you have spoken to Jens Heidegger lately, he's probably given you an earful of about the power of co-innovation. But co-innovation is real. Co-innovation happens when inventors and engineers from different industries with different mindsets all work on the same problem at the same time. They have different approaches and different solutions, and they do inspire each other and spur each other on to be better and better. And if you want to take a snapshot of this process of co-innovation, then there is no better place than IFA. I'm pleased to announce that the opening keynote at IFA 2019 will be delivered by Richard Yu, the CEO of Huawei. Huawei needs no further introduction, and I'm sure you agree that this will be a keynote where you have to come early to ensure a seat. And I can also confirm our second keynote speaker at IFA Berlin 2019. He's the president of a company that is a key player when it comes to 5G connectivity. It's Cristiano Amon, the president of Qualcomm. For Qualcomm, for Huawei, and for all the other speakers and exhibitors in Berlin, IFA will be a platform that brings together manufacturers, retailers, service providers, media, and consumers. IFA Berlin is a platform like no other because of both the breadth of our offering and our global reach. But it's not just about who's coming to Berlin or here. We are a global network connecting Europe, the Americas, and Asia. We are where our partners need us. So in just a few weeks, in New York with the CE Week, we will run a networking and retail platform, because that's what is needed there. Then in mid-September, you will have IFA Berlin. And at the end of the month, from the 19th until the 21st of September, with CE China in Guangzhou, we offer a platform to showcase the innovation launched at IFA Berlin, to drive its market entry across Asia, and of course, in China, which undoubtedly continues to be the world's most dynamic market. IFA Berlin is now a global network and a platform for experiences, because however digital you are, nothing, absolutely nothing, beats the efficiency of all the face-to-face meetings at IFA, CE Week, and CE China, or the intensity of roaming the halls at Messe Berlin. By demonstrating and experiencing products in real life, that's one of the ways of building trust. Earlier, I mentioned the fantastic growth of our innovation hub, IFA Next. Yes, it is a success story within IFA's success story. IFA Next is an amazing platform for startups because they don't have to build a booth. They can simply walk in, go to their prefab stand, and get ready to tell their story, to do their pitch. But we also wondered what could make IFA Next even better. We believe that our visitors will benefit if they can take a deep dive into the startup scene of one specific country. As you know, IFA Next is a carefully curated event. That's why we were very choosy until we found the perfect global partner country for the IFA Next 2019, Japan.